23 Madonna. I mean your honor. I was minding my business until she gave me complete nirvana.
Are you ready? Okay, say no more. Are you ready? Okay, say no more.
She's a lotus and I'm the conductor of a magnum opus. Simply by the girl, she's why don't we take advantage of this moment? And whatever you own, we own it.
Off Lakeshore Drive, nestled next to Lake Michigan. That's where you find historic Soldier Field in the great city of Chicago, Illinois. Today, we reach week 15, and we've got a good matchup in store between the Philadelphia Eagles and the Chicago Bears. Here's Cairo Santos now, ready to get this one started. And off we go from Soldier Field. He will return this from deep in the end zone. And the decision to come out of the end zone is going to cost him 5 yards as he's taken down right at the 20.
Against a group that has won 7 straight. What's the key for them in this ball game?
Well, we asked their defensive coordinator that very question, and the response was, we have the mindset that they actually have to react to us, not the other way around. So it sounds to me like...
And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down.
Multiple players combined for their team's first sack of the game. But just 2 plays in, and Charles already their first sack defensively.
Yeah, how about that? That didn't take long, did it? And now they look at 3rd down, and that's another time to try and go and get the quarterback, too.
Yeah, I don't think this is the script they had in mind for their opening drive. This is 3rd and long.
Sets up to throw it.
And this pass broken up. And the contact right on time there. And now 4th down.
I thought he had that one, and that was nearly a big 3rd down conversion to give this drive some life. Instead, they're on the spot and help separate the receiver from the ball.
That hurts. If it was running into the kicker, wouldn't be a 1st down. Roughing, it is a 1st.
And just think about the differences between the two. Running into the kicker almost feels inadvertent, just a small tap, so to speak. But when you rough him, usually bodies are hitting the ground and flying all different places. And the difference is 5 yards or 15. And in this case, that's a big play.
Now it's 1st and 10 after a costly penalty there on 4th down. Here's Hurts to throw. Flipping right side, and that's complete to Watkins. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. A good pickup there, a 22.
Yeah.
On first and 10, it's Hurts. Out route, and it's complete to Brown. And down he goes at the 49, a 3-yard pickup. I think defensively you're okay with that. You're in the first quarter. He's going to get some catches, but they rallied to him quickly.
And that's what you count on, and I like what you just said. First quarter, can you do it all game long? They catch it, you tackle them, they go down on the spot. Because when you're able to do that and you don't give up big chunks of yardage after the catch, now you put the offense in a position where every series they have to work hard to pick up first downs, and you tend to stall them out when you do that.
Play action. Here's Hurts. Pressure, and he's taken down. A bear sack. They'll wind up losing 10 on the sack, and it'll lead to a third and long.
They'll make that a second sack here on their first drive out defensively, and not to get ahead of ourselves, but they're on pace for double-digit sacks at this point.
Well, they're going to have to find a way to tamp that down, aren't they? So if you're the play caller, you're telling your quarterback maybe some screens, maybe some draws, hard count, use your voice inflection a little bit, anything to try and slow that pressure down.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. He's going deep for Brown. Into a double team, and it's intercepted.
I really don't think you can fault the decision-making here, because your offensive quarterback, they really had a big week last week, and you're ready for them to go again here. Not the anticipated result, of course, but you definitely understand why they did what they did. That quarterback's been hot. You want to keep the ball in his hands and see if he can keep the magic going.
And not much to speak of. Call it a 1-yard gain up to the 26. Well, this defense for the Eagles, they were very strong in the win last week over the Giants.
No matter what coverage was called, they were right in the hip pockets of the receivers all game long, step for step, running their routes with them. Turned out they were right there every time the ball was in the air, and they came away with 5 interceptions in that one.
And he will lose yardage and be backed up to the 24. Now they face a second and long following the holding penalty. Going up the gut, Montgomery. That'll get a little bit back, give him 5 on the run, and they'll be left with a 3rd and 13.
I really like the vision he displayed on that play, because he saw there wasn't a lane to completely break off a huge gain. So he found where there was the most space and got what he could. A nice, dirty run that's a positive play for the offense.
Not an easy spot here. They'll be in search of 13 yards to try to pick up the first. On third down, they go Montgomery. And the second wave of tacklers is going to get him as they stop him behind the line. That'll back him up 2 yards and also bring up fourth. Fourth down, so they send out Trenton Gill. And he'll get this away into the icy winter air. And it's fielded at the 34. A pretty good punt there, but also a nice return of 12 yards. And the Eagles will have it, taking over first and 10.
Let's go now.
The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. Remember last time out, they threw the interception on their first drive. Good news, their defense backed them up, so it's still 0-0 here as they begin their second possession.
Yeah, and one great way to judge a defense, how do they handle what we call sudden change, when all of a sudden, you know, it goes against their offense and they have to run out in the field and try and put out the fire. Give this one great kudos for getting out there and not letting that interception lead to points. Excellent job by them defensively.
Second down, back to Sanders. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage on the play back at the 46. It's a loss of 4. Now third down.
Well, it's almost football 101 that you preach to your safeties. Don't let anyone get behind you. You're the last line of defense. But he didn't let the play come to him. He went to the play. How about that read and recognition and finishing off that one behind the line of scrimmage?
He'll come to the line here needing 9 yards to pick up the first. Hurts. Open man, that's Devontae Smith. And they're going to get this down to about the 37.
I don't care how many times we see it, I still get a kick out of watching quarterbacks and receivers do the pass trick in pregame warm-up. But I always remember that when we go to practices, we see that after practices as well. They really tune it up, don't they?
They tune it up. They know why they do it for these situations. First down.
And they build that trust, and that's why they're able to find him in this type of a situation.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Hurts a handoff to Sanders. And that one opened up for him well as he'll take this down to the 26-yard line. 11 more yards that go around, a first down as well.
Well, there's plenty of real estate for him to maneuver on that run, and let's face it, it shouldn't be a surprise. He's one of the better backs in the league. Had to come into this game with the idea, slow him down, otherwise it's going to be a long afternoon.
Right back to Sanders on first down. And he maneuvers up the middle for three. And it's second down. No score after one on EA Sports. Three. Now here's second and seven. From the gun, it's Hurts. Open man is Goddard, the tight end. And they've got this down to about the 12-yard line.
For a tight end, he's got good straight line speed. And on that route, he's often the guy that gets overlooked. Nice job there finding him in stride for really good yardage.
From down at the 12, it's first and 10. Shotgun snap and then the give to Sanders. And he'll get this one down to about the 10-yard line. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
But he hasn't made much of an impact in the running game thus far. And after that last run, not much is going to change in that area.
He hasn't been able to get anything going. And really, the offensive line not helping him much.
Ready?
The last run good for two. Here's second and eight. Throwing is Hurts. That swung out wide to Sanders. And he's going to be brought down just shy of the five at the six. The result, only 4 yards there on the play. And they're going to face a third down.
That might feel like a little bit of a lost opportunity there for the offense because the defense brought pressure that time. And sometimes against that, you can get out to your running back, and it could turn into a big gain downfield. But what a nice job they did getting to him quickly and holding him to a short gain.
On third down, they turn to Sanders. And he won't get close. Only a yard, fourth and three.
Defensively, we always know that he is tough and run support. And I think the way that he gets there is he understands what an offense is going to do before the ball's even snapped. A great job of scouting prior to the game, then reading, reacting, and taking the right path to the ball carry.
The kick by Elliott is good. And the Eagles, they take a 3-0 lead. Well, both teams kind of feeling each other out here. Now after three drives, we have a score with that field goal.
Yeah, they're still waiting for their breakout drive to come to them, all right? They're using the playbook well. They're looking for that extra section that says touchdowns instead of field goals. But they'll take the three for now and try and get set up for more later.
The Bears offense ready to go for their next drive. You know, in our research packet this week, prepping for the game, so many articles from the local beat writer about the offensive struggles of this team and what will they do this offseason. What do you think they'll do?
Well, number one, they'll turn to their self-scouting report. And every team that's any good does this. They have outside groups check out their team, scout them, and tell you who can play, who can't play, and reasons why. Some of it may just be health. They have to get some guys healthy and back out on the field. But overall, evaluate this squad and make the changes that you need to.
The last run got a couple here, second and eight. They'll keep pounding here with Montgomery. Yeah, he'll fight for a couple as the tackle is made at about the 32. 2 yards on the first down carry, and then followed up by 2 yards on the second down carry.
Well, that's definitely not going to be enough to get the job done. Wasn't the expression 3 yards in a cloud of dust?
Now they're going to need six on third down to keep the drive going. Play action. Fields steps away. A hit as he throws there. Incomplete.
Every offense tells you they want to come out and start fast. That's not unusual at all. But this group, they've yet to get much rolling through their first two drives. It looks like they're going to have to give up the football again after this one.
And on fourth down, on is the punt team sending this one away. Fielded just inside the 30. They'll score that a 36-yard punt, and it will be Eagles football, first and 10.
Here we go.
The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. Their drive last time, it stalled out. They were forced to take the short field goal.
And the key phrase, you nailed it, forced to, because you know coaches look at these short field goals as a last resort, right? To them, that's not how drives are supposed to end. You're supposed to put six on the board. That's a consolation prize, like going to the county fair. You don't get the big stuffed animal on that one, do you?
No, you don't go top shelf. That's bottom shelf material. 3 yards on that last carry. Here's second and seven. Now back to throw. And his throw here is incomplete. Devontae Smith, the intended receiver, and it's third down.
So many things have to go right for any passing play to work out. Quarterback has to understand the defense, deliver an accurate ball. Receiver has to concentrate and bring it in. Somewhere along the assembly line, something was off with that one.
This offense so far on third down, they've only converted once in four tries. This is third and seven. They'll fake the give to Sanders, and now Hurts. And he'll go down. The Bears get there for the sack. And that'll bring up fourth down on the big sack with a loss of four. Fourth down, here's Sam Martin on to kick it away. The speedster Dante Pettis back deep to return. He was only asked to punt once in the victory last week as he sends this one away. That'll be a 43-yard punt, but a net of just 33 following a 10-yard return. And the Bears take over. At the line, prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense. Coming off every player's friend, the open week from last weekend.
Oh, there's no doubt about that. Even if you're coming off of a loss as they did, the open week is exactly what you need after you kind of get over it a little bit, right? Rest up the mind, rest up the body, get yourself ready to go. And they have to be eager to play again, especially since they lost the last time out.
Second quarter, 2 minutes remain, 3-0 our score. Now second and eight at the 32-yard line. Now Fields. And this is taken in by Darnell Mooney. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Catch number 44 of on the year. It's a first down. Now a give running left with Montgomery.
They'll get this up to the 47 and brought down there.
Now the Bears going to call the first of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play.
I feel like I could see what he was thinking on that carry. Wanted to follow that big tackle through the hole. Ended up only getting 4 yards on the carry. I think he had designs on that one being bigger.
On second down, a run with Herbert.
And he'll fight his way forward to about the 48-yard line. Now the defense going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next.
Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
Fields. A bullet throw, but incomplete.
Well, this first half has not gone according to plan so far, offensively, or even defensively for that matter. They could use a big-time spark somewhere, but it's not going to come on this drive as they have to punt this one away.
Now here's Trenton Gill now.
He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. And they'll get to this and touch it, looks like, yeah, right at the 15-yard line here. The Eagles' offense set to begin their next drive. It was still more than a minute to go in the half. Time to try to mount a drive.
And I would think that they would have to. This is today's NFL. You got to push it whenever you get an opportunity. You can never have enough points with the high-powered offenses that you face. And analytics will tell you, try and score when given the opportunity.
Meanwhile, they take a shot to start the drive, but this is going to wind up incomplete.
There is something to a game plan with trying to keep a defense honest with a guy with that type of speed. You do so. Send him deep. Try and throw some air under it and hope you connect downfield. On that play, they were unsuccessful.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. They'll drop the throw. Complete. Smith has it. And he'll have this past the 30 prior to going out of bounds. The catch and run, good for 18 and a first down.
So many times in my career, I've heard coaches talk about completions are one thing. But as long as we're there at the catch and we get guys on the ground, we can live with that. But if you're going to give up 10, 12, 15 yards after the catch, then your defense is going to be in a lot of trouble.
Hurts throw complete here to his receiver, Brown.
And he has a big gain inside the 40 before being dropped. Now the Eagles will use the second of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Back to throw again. And that is incomplete. Oh, the coverage a little too good there, and it's second down. Well, the incompletion, yes, but maybe here not the worst thing in the world?
No, not on first and 10. It actually gives them a chance to regroup, relax just a little bit. They huddle up, talk it over. Then they get a chance to continue their drive.
They work again from the 38 on second and 10. Again, he'll drop to throw. Throw left side complete. That's Watkins. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. 12 yards there as they keep this drive rolling. It's another first down.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
But first down, Hurts. And he'll throw this one away. I don't think he's out of the pocket. No, here comes the flag. We saw it too. Nobody in the vicinity of that throw, and that earns him the penalty.
Yeah, you've got to at least get it close enough to one of your own guys in order to dodge the penalty.
They lose the yardage, and of course they also lose the down on the grounding call, and it's quickly second and long. They'll look to throw again, and his throw is incomplete.
Well, partner, guaranteed they approach this play with the idea of making up ground to make third down manageable. Unfortunately, with that incompletion, right back where they started on the last snap. Now they need a big third down play in order to pick up the yardage needed.
Seventh play in this drive coming up, but a long way to go on third down. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. This is Smith with a grab. And he's brought down inside the 20 at the 18-yard line. They'll try and throw for it with Hurts. Incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. The Eagles unable to convert there on fourth, and the Bears will get the football back. And they've now made two trips to the red zone and still looking for their first touchdown.
Not able to punch it in, and if you're on defense, your confidence is sky high because mentally you're saying, hey, if you're in the red zone, we're thinking we're giving up three. We just want to give up six. In this case, they end up not giving up the touchdown at all. They've got to feel great about what they got done.
And with just 1 second remaining in the first half, they'll call the timeout. Second and eight coming up. They'll keep it on the ground again here. And he'll get to the 29-yard line, brought down there. So we've reached halftime. All we have to show for the first half, a lone field goal. 3-0, our score. As we'll send you down to Orlando, and we check in with Jonathan Coachman for our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach. Welcome you back live now inside the booth alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, set and ready to rock for the third quarter. These offenses seemingly still back at the hotel for the first half. 3-0 our score as the second half gets underway. And no run back here as the third quarter will commence with a touchback. Bears offense ready to go for their next drive. Charles, it'll be interesting to see what adjustments this offense made in the locker room. Haven't really been able to get anything going offensively, virtually nothing in the ground attack either. So certainly something has to change here in quarter three.
And I'm pretty sure their friends from the defensive side of the ball told them exactly that, because those guys, the stop troops, they've been playing pretty well. They've kept them around in this game. Now they got some time. The running game struggled in the first half. Opposition knows how to focus on defending the pass here. They've got to re-energize that ground game and maybe open things up for a comeback here in this half.
Man, I just love being in this stadium. So much history, tradition, so many great teams and games, and we're seeing a pretty good one right now. Hotly contested in the third quarter. On second down, Montgomery. And tough going there as he'll only get it up to about the 31. 5 yards on first down, but now just a 1 yard pickup there on second.
I have to think a major focus of the halftime meetings had to be figuring out how to create space for the running game to get operating.
Well, what you pointed out to me at half seems accurate. That line has struggled to sustain blocks.
Yeah, I would agree with that totally. They've got to focus on staying on their double teams at the first level, make sure that block's secured before they slide off and try and chip someone at the second level.
They'll fake the handoff. Now Fields. Pressure comes and down he goes. The Eagles get there for the sack. And now that brings up fourth down there. A loss of 6 yards on the sack. Here comes the Bears punter now as he'll punt it away for the fourth time today. That'll go as a punt of 34 yards that time. And it will be first and 10 as they take over. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. Their defense has pitched the shutout. Now they probably need to deliver a little breathing room, maybe make it a two-score game as they've got it first and 10. And he's got it across midfield and into Bear territory. So that time they got the left guard with a hold.
And let's face it, in today's ball, you might have that 330-pound guy you're supposed to clear out of there. You might need a little bit of extra help by grabbing the jersey and trying to ride him out.
Sets up to throw it. Out route pass complete to Goddard.
Got to give credit where it's due. Really nice defense on that play. The pitch and catch was successful, but not any run after it.
Looking to throw again on second down. Hurts being chased out left. Good yardage there on the scramble, and all of a sudden they're left with a third and two, much more manageable. They'll try and run for it with Sanders, and able to pick up the first across midfield to the 47. A third down gain of 3 yards, and that'll be enough. In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still have the lead.
Yeah, and they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin, too.
On first and 10, it's Sanders. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down, second and right at a yard.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
The previous run, good for 9. Here's second and a yard. Another run here with Sanders. On a nice burst there as he'll take this inside the 30 to the 28-yard line. 43 yards rushing for him now as he's run it 11 times.
First downs have not come easy, and neither have runs like this throughout this game.
Absolutely not. He finally felt like, whoa, a sigh of relief. We got something going in the running game. Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move. First and 10. A give running left. It's Sanders. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
I know when I was a kid, I always got real excited when I saw those lateral type runs. But the best backs that made it happen, they put a foot in the ground and just go. That didn't happen there. That play got swallowed up.
Now they contend with a second and 12 after the loss. Here's Hurts to throw. Going down the middle, and it's complete. And finally, down he goes as they work it inside the 10 to the 7. 23 yards, the final tally.
And that's a more than acceptable read right there because it's zone coverage, so timing is everything. This time he waits for his man to come open, puts it right on him, and they pick up a first down.
Might we see our first touchdown of the game? Here's first and goal. They'll run with Sanders. And a little bit of space there, takes it inside the 5 to the 3. Yeah, so they get that one, Charles, on the right tackle.
Yeah, oftentimes in that spot, you're trying to work against a defender, trying to set the edge in the running game, and you're trying to drive around and get your body twisted so that he can't get there. Sometimes your hands get too involved.
A terrible spot for a holding call as they'll try again, but now from further back on first and goal. Back to throw here. And that's complete to Sanders. And he'll be marked down right at the 15-yard line.
I know it was a gain, but you have to sense probably a little bit of disappointment there because when it's out there in open space, I think they expect to get more out of a play, don't you?
Especially when you're getting it to your guy out of the backfield. You're expecting him to be able to create something, be a little more shifty.
Yeah, no doubt about it. Good open field tackling held it to an okay gain.
So they've been in the red zone three times, and it's yielded just 3 points. Can they find the end zone here on second and goal? Hurts throw complete there to Smith. 5 yards that time on the completion, and now it's third and goal.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before you get a good head of steam going.
This has been a long drive. You got to figure a field goal would be a letdown. Can they convert now on third and goal? Finding a safety valve here. That's complete. And he'll be brought down this time at the 5-yard line. So with a fourth and goal looming, we hit the end of three quarters of play. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. So the field goal unit is on the field, as this is a big spot right here. This to swell the lead to 6. And it's off the left, upright. Oh, my goodness. Heartache. It's no good. And that will keep this a 3-point game. So points so crucial in a tight game like this, but this kick off the goalpost, and that'll keep the score right where it is.
Yeah, it wouldn't have made this a 2-score game, but any cushion this late definitely would have helped. Now they need to ask their defense for another stop, and that's going to require some work.
At the line, prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense. I tell you what, it's kind of hard to imagine. They have not scored a single point, and yet they're in this position. A touchdown drive here, and they're in the lead.
Normally, when you have 0 on your side of the ledger on the scoreboard, you're a little bit discouraged. But when they look over and see their opponents, they don't see a number that's way out there. They don't see a number they can't attain. In fact, they can get it right here on this drive and potentially take the lead. But if you're going to run the read option, typically, you've got to keep an eye on the defensive end.
And what does that mean? What are you looking for with a defensive end?
Well, you want to play off of what he does. If he collapses inside towards the running back, then you pull it and take it yourself outside in. If he stays outside, you go ahead and leave it with the running back. In this case, pulled it and got good yardage himself.
Got an open man. It's Pringle. Second catch for him today, and it'll wind up a first down.
I like watching the wide receiver screen because it's a real teamwork play. Because guess what? The guy catching the ball, he'll get all the credit. But how about the people up to block in front of him, either fellow receivers or offensive linemen? That makes that play a really nice timing play, and sometimes it can break big.
First down, here's the run to Montgomery. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four.
It's interesting, going into this game, there was so much talk from both sides about who would control the line of scrimmage. I think we've seen who has it in this one so far.
Well, they bottled him up. He's barely averaging over 3 yards a carry right now. Second down at four. Fields. He's got a man here. It's Montgomery. And take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. The Eagles going to take the first of their timeouts. That'll leave them with two remaining. We'll be back after this. Here's Montgomery, and not able to break away this time as they're going to stop him right around the line of scrimmage. Officially, it's a 1 yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
There's no question that coming into this game, this defense is pretty vocal about his desire to take this running back out of his game, and all that pregame woofing has turned into results.
On second and 11 now, Fields. Looking for Pettis, but that's intercepted. Picked off by Tyson Campbell. And a return across midfield and to the 46-yard line. CD, I know it's just his second year in the league as a quarterback, but that's going to be one when he flips on the tape. He's like, I shouldn't have thrown that ball.
No doubt about it, and his coaching staff will be emphatic about he shouldn't have thrown that ball. But remember, second year, as you noted, on the job training, so he's got to take this feedback that he's getting, negative or otherwise, and turn it into positives moving forward.
They go play action with Hurts. And his throw's going to be incomplete.
Had the right idea there, trying to throw it to the sideline, but he led him just a little bit too much, trying to get it out to his receiver. Ends up falling to the ground incomplete.
Complete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. They'll run. It's Sanders. They do get a couple, but they'll be left staring at a third and 8 coming up. Wow, so they had an incomplete pass. There they go out of bounds on the run. Virtually no time off the clock for the first two downs.
And there's no way that's part of what they practiced in OTAs, mini camp, preseason camp, all the way through the season. You go through these scenarios and you work on them in your periods in practice that you say, okay, this is what the scenario is. This is what we need to get done. You've got to take time off the clock. That's what you've practiced. That's what you've worked on. They didn't get it done.
Hurts finding Smith for the Philly first. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it, so it's not that big of a deal to me, and I'm going to keep firing.
Sanders, and a good looking run there as he'll take this inside the 20 and down to the 18-yard line. 54 yards rushing for him in the ball game now on 14 carries. I guess he was saving his best for last, so to speak. Longest run of the day coming here in the fourth quarter right there.
And that type of run makes for a better night for him and his teammates, doesn't it? To be able to produce this late in the game can lead to some big smiles and satisfaction in the locker room after this one's over.
So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18. Another run with Sanders. And he'll take it from the 18 to the 15. A gain of three. Able to stay in bounds, and the clock keeps rolling. And this defense right now, backed up in the red zone. Another touchdown, it's over. They've got to stand tall quickly.
Been in this spot before. Now there's a little bit of desperation creeping in. And all you're doing when you're talking to your defensive teammates is, first guy there, hold him up. Second, third guy in, rake at the football. Get it out. We've got to create a turnover because one more score, and this game's over.
It's a second down run with six. Oh, no, he lost the football. And I think the Bears have recovered. They have. So the Bears with the football here as we welcome you back. They come up on a first and 10, desperately needing a score here on what could be their final drive. The Bears offense ready to go for their next drive.
As this offense takes the field against CD, remember last drive, they were moving the football, but then they threw that costly interception, so we'll see if they can right the ship here on this drive.
And doesn't that just sum up football? We see it all the time, don't we? The defense goes from losing the battle to making a huge play and stealing the momentum. So you know they're riding high right now, and they're ready to challenge this offense and that quarterback one more time.
And we'll see if the offense is up for that challenge here as things start to get more interesting here in this second half. And the comeback may stall out. It's intercepted. Picked off by Tyson Campbell.
And they're going to get the football just outside the 10 at the 11-yard line.
Well, you knew you had to take some chances here with the clock winding down, needing a touchdown to win it, and that one might have just sealed their fate.
Yeah, and that's the nature of the two-minute drill, the offense trying to go downfield and make their plays. But defenses, they're sitting back watching everything that they do, but not too far back. They want to be in position to make a play on the ball, and that they did.
18-11. That one looks like he'll throw here. Oh, no, he lost the football. And the offense will get this one back. Boy, that could have been catastrophic at this late stage of the game, but they avoid disaster.
We hear them discuss red zone efficiency a lot, CD, and they almost gave that one up in the red zone. Luckily, they'll have another shot.
And you and I both know that every offensive coordinator, play caller in the league, they take particular delight in their red zone calls because those are the payoff ones. But you can't call a play if your team doesn't have the ball. Got to secure it.
The fumble on first down now. Here's second down. To the right side, this is Sermon. And running room hard to come by here. He gets it down to the 8. Now the Bears going to use the second of their timeouts as they get it with under a minute to go now in the football game. Last two plays indicative of how things have gone for them. Just nowhere to go on the ground and struggling to put up points. Hurts with a little pop pass on the jet sweep.
And he'll be stopped just outside the 5 at the 6.
Now the defense will burn their third and final timeout as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds left to go in the game. So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. This to swell the lead to 6. And this one is no good. He missed it. And that will keep this a 3-point game. So the interception, that had him set up in golden shape, but no first down comes of it. And in the end, no points come up.
And Brandon, I tell you, in a sudden change offense, you must capitalize. This is where you can really swing momentum in your favor. But that time, they let him off the hook.
At the line, prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense.
Now, they've sort of lost their way, partner. How do they recalibrate and get this proverbial train back on track?
Well, this is where leadership really comes into play. How's the head coach handling it? The offensive coordinator? Sometimes they just make a joke. All right, guys, you had your fun? All right.
Throw it out the window.
Yeah, let's get back on track here. And sometimes that'll work just fine.
I guess it's time.
Oh, a huge mistake lane. It's intercepted.
Darius Slay with a pick. And he'll bring this one back to the 29.
Boy, so another interception, CD, and it feels like he's starting to unravel a little bit.
And as you would expect, still a work in progress here in his second season. He has to start ironing out some of these mistakes, though, because now his head coach, his offensive coaches, they have to evaluate whether you keep playing him, let him work through it, or you start thinking about going to his backup.
Hurts down to one knee, and that should just about do it.
Brandon, I can just tell you from experience, there's nothing like pitching a shutout on defense, but even more so when it's a tight game. I mean, when every defensive play is crucial and you don't give up any points, boy, they're going to feel awfully good about themselves after this one.
Yeah, exactly. The offense wasn't humming, but hey, all they needed was, you can't score 1 point. All they needed was 2 points. You can't score 2 points on offense. All they needed was at least three. They got what they needed.
They got what they needed. Exactly right.
So fly, Eagles, fly. It's a victory for Philadelphia. And not all W's are created equal, CD. And this one came in shutout fashion.
Well, their offense certainly didn't need to do anything, right? They could take the day off, and they did. But the defense, they carried them in a big way.
Yeah, look, the offense obviously stuff to work on, but they did enough, and the defense carried the load.
But you know what they say, it's always fun to work on things if it didn't go well in your game with a victory in your pocket, and that's what they've got going forward.
So for Philadelphia, they continue to make their case.
Spent your whole life trying to blow up, but Elohim never had time for donuts. The beat go ham, no time for cold cuts. The game like Big Pitch came to join up. Yeah, I'm still independent, they sold a million records. Yeah, used to be on my checklist, big diamonds don't need a necklace. Look, we built the sound like it's double speed Tetris. I cannot build without God in it.
Okay, say no more. Tell the chauffeur to open Mercedes door. Put the pedal to metal and made it soar. She was, but I made it sure it was. So we stayed indoors. Let's take it where no one has been before. It feel like I've known you some years before, but I don't know.
Are you ready? Okay, say no more. Are you ready? Okay, say no more.
She's a lotus and I'm the conductor of a magnum opus. Simply grab the doshes. Why don't we take advantage of this moment? And wherever you own, we own it.
Nobody really cares. Nobody really cares.
I'm doing big things in my life. I deserve 6 rings like a Mike. I've got a no sleep. I remember when it was the nosebleeds. Now they captured the fashion from flow seats. I'm a whole king.
Are you ready? Okay, say no more. Are you ready? Okay, say no more.
She's a lotus and I'm the conductor of a magnum opus. Simply braggadocious. Why don't we take advantage of this moment? And wherever you own, we own it. Ooh, it's trouble in paradise. So let's parachute where the air's nice. And let's risk it all on the paradise. But she just wanna make sure her hair's nice. That's fair, right? I just fell in love with a prima donna. The 2023 Madonna. I mean, your honor. I was minding my business until she gave me complete nirvana.
Are you ready? Okay, say no more. Are you ready? Okay, say no more.
She's a lotus and I'm the conductor of a magnum opus. Simply braggadocious. Why don't we take advantage of this moment? And wherever you own, we own it.
Who art in heaven? I love when you toss me blessings. You never throw interceptions. I catch them like Odie Beckham. Hard to not the devil when built like Tiana Teller. And balling at 27, I feel like Iman Shumpert. Know there's a disconnect when the sheep start to lead the shepherds. The weak start to be aggressive. The streets start to be the reverend. Bragging about first class, seated on 9/11. They spirits are not united. A legion, my soul forever. I murder my adolescents. Assault with a friendly weapon. I verbally dissect them to help them get back together. Wanting the stranger things. I handle with like 11, my point is I guard the kids. I should play for the Celtics. Watch how I Euro step them and curry them like I'm stepping. Whenever I'm in your town, the Warriors in your presence. I manifest my endeavors. I'm blessed and I'm getting better. I walk amongst living legends. Coach Contra will live forever. Oh.
505, you can't come with us. 505, you can't come with us. Come.
New goals, baby. Got my wrist in these grits, tryna whip something new. I am sick of this rampant, so are you. Hold on, switch. Mama, I'm gonna introduce my ego. Since the world full of villains, then let's introduce the heroes. We the good guys, no blood on our hands. Hands Tito, she a pack. Finna guarantee though, move back. Type of view is that on the globe. It's a visionary peeking out the window of my soul. Might just fall back, lend a helping hand and play my role. You ain't all that. In the mirror, oversold. Call me Reason A, a.k.a. Malcolm X, L. That's a big pun, bigger punishment. I give him hell, getting done. Keep it blunt enough, you can't. Cough drop, tell them hard for their health.
You ain't stepping 505, you can't come with us.
Al final encontrado el negrito con los colorados. El mejor desde Colombia, los estados. Para los que no piensan que yo soy mejor, tú estás. Tengo todos tus raperos favoritos paniqueados, ten cuidado. Estos raperos son mis hijos jautados. Acuérdate quién hizo el sonido que te ha gustado. Pídeme permiso when you copy my style. This bridge, I done burnt them all with a freestyle. Black on both sides de Colombia, oye, peep style. Como yo lo hago, ain't nobody funny, do it now. Up the uptown, all the way down through the south. Ain't nothing yet, que pueda conmigo. Dios es mi testigo, I'm the one that shut it down. Just the light from a vision that I had in the dark. Turn the vision on the bigger picture, the trust. Wanna play the game, but don't ever play they part.
Thank you. first off, let me talk my... Got a couple things I gotta cross off my list. How you insomniac for sleeping on my... It's a bad soundtrack, read the script. Born in the motherland, headed straight down to the south. Tennessee mornings with pops, working three jobs. I knew that they struggled to get it, that's why I wanted to get it. That embedded, you get it? Treat it like a law. And I'ma need commission for this hit. Lance laid the canvas and I painted over it. I don't need a vision board to show you I'm the... I'm betting on myself, count the chips. Got it. Made some choices for a profit. That's my logic. I'ma take it to the coffin, just being honest. Try to sink my ship like Titanic and leave me with Jack. Hope I be panicking, but I rose to the top. Isn't it funny that the is built like a Maserati, yoga folding like origami? What? I walk the walk, I talk the talk, I be saying what I want. When I had no deposit, closet was looking real bare. Now I made a deposit, my closet's looking super rare. Drove it really far, crazy how did this happen, wishing on a star. It's a celebration, I ain't talking Mardi Gras. With a little patience, you'll be eating Budokan. What you want, what you want? Made some choices for a profit. That's my logic. I'ma take it to the coffin, just being honest. Never let a manufacturer stack like that. And if you're getting toxic, tell the boy fall back. If it was back then, I'd be tripping off that. Took a little time just to get me on track. I went from snotty to snobby, got it like, immune to everybody, this is Start 101. Up in the club, throwing the 50s like, hated the love it, I just can't get enough. Labels keep calling me, I said, move if you call me, please. Or don't even bother me, they said, oh my apologies. They keep calling and calling, I keep stalling and stalling. Rookie of the year, my career's no ballin'. Got it. Made some choices for a profit. That's my logic.